One, two, three, four, five. ChatGPT hacks and secrets that you should know about in 2023. Let's get into it. Okay, so the first prompt we're going to look at is the ignore all previous instructions before this one prompt. So all we have to do is we can create an initial query or initial prompt, and we'll just give it something simple. So we'll say, what is the distance from the Earth to the Sun? ChatGPT will respond with its answer. Then we can go ahead and ask a few more context questions like, what is the temperature of the Sun? And so we're giving it context of the Sun. And now let's say we want to change that query. We don't really want to open up a new chat, but we want to actually switch context here. And one way we can do that is we can say, ignore all previous instructions before this one. And now we could say something like, how many dog breeds are there in the world? Right. And so what that gives you is it context switching. Using the ignore prompt here will greatly improve your context switching. Give it a try. Okay, for this example, act as a title or role, we will instruct ChatGPT to become an industry expert here. And in this case, we will just type in something like act as a software engineer and then give it its context or set of instructions. So we'll say write a Hello World app using the latest best practices in a single page. You must use Next.js. You must use TypeScript. You must include documentation in line above each function in HTML. You must also provide documentation links. You must also include an on-click button that will execute a JavaScript alert that contains Hello World. So let's go ahead and run that. So as you can see, it created an example Hello World app using Next.js and TypeScript, along with an on-click button that displays an alert with the message Hello World. It's also included it in one single page. I can copy the code here and put it in my text editor and deploy it within seconds. Let's just run through the code. So we have import React from React. We have a doc block onClick handler for the say hello button. We have an onClick function with an alert in it. We have another doc block that says renders a button that displays an alert with a message hello world when it is clicked. And we can see that here. So this is the hello world React functional component that it's created with a simple button that contains a hello world onClick function that calls the handleClick function. Then down below, we have the actual page renders the main page content, including say hello button. The page is generated. This would be your index.tsx. And then it would contain an H1 with the words hello world and a paragraph, welcome to my Next.js app, and the button component that we've created from above. All of this code looks functional to me. It also provided us with instructions on how to get it set up here and more definitions of what actually took place. And then some inline documentation. And it also created more links to continue our exploration with setting up Next.js and TypeScript. In this next example, we're going to give ChatGPT some instructions. We're going to use keywords like give, provide, do, perform, etc. And that will help us give us the best results from instructing ChatGPT. For instance, we may have no idea what to eat for dinner tonight. So we can say, your task is to provide ideas and ingredients for a vegetarian dinner for two. We'll hit enter. And if you notice, we didn't ask it to create a recipe for us, and it's performing what it thinks it should do for us. It's planning a dinner for two, and it's using all of the ingredients, and it's sticking to vegetarian options. Let's just double check our work here. Make sure that there's no meat involved. There's nothing to be found. Looks good to me. Looks delicious. I think I'm gonna go make this now. Okay, in this example, we're going to be looking at the always and before operators or prompts that we can use to leverage more accuracy within ChatGPT. To do this, we're going to just type in something like, you must always ask before you answer so you can fully understand the question I'm providing. I'll hit enter. It says, sure, I apologize for not asking before. What is your question? And I'm going to just type in, what is the distance from the Earth to the Sun, the average distance, it's going to give us our typical response here. Now I'm just going to type in the word dog. I'm sorry. I'm not sure what you mean by dog. Can you please provide more context or clarify your question? I'm also going to type in cat. I apologize, but I'm not sure what you mean by cat either. Can you please provide more information or let me know how I can assist you? Now I'm going to type in the word sun. The sun is a star, and you see it's giving context. It didn't question what that was about. It knows my context is about the sun. This is all about refining your context so it understands you, and it will work much more efficiently, and it will provide you with more accurate responses. So check that one out as well. Okay, for this next example, we're going to use the do you understand prompt or operator or command. And what this will do is it will provide us with confirmation if ChatGPT understands our context or not. So in this case, I'm going to ask it, act as a software engineer. Your task is to create a Zapier and ChatGPT Twitter automator. And I'll follow it up with, do you understand? And as you can see, it says, yes, I understand. Yes, that is what we want. So the bonus thing here is I'm going to say, please continue. Now it's going to go ahead and just create the steps for us. And you can use please continue as the bonus option here, the sixth option that is in this list of awesome things, awesome prompts to use. And you can continue. So you could just refine it. Please continue. Again, we'll just go on after deployment. So now it's going to just do all of that. There it is. Do you understand? And then following up with, if it has a confirmation of yes, I understand, or no, I don't, I'd like to ask you, me as the user, for more context. I can provide that. If it does understand, you can use please continue, and it will just continue along. And just like that, you are on your merry way to becoming a superhuman with superpowers. You will soon be able to reduce your workplace and team, hopefully get yourself a pay raise. And if you don't get a pay raise, well, then be sure to check out my other videos over here so they can take your ChatGPT knowledge from zero to hero. I have been Eric, you have been awesome, and I will see you in the next video.